Well, hello, everybody.
Wow, that was loud.
I have a lame card because I've never done this before, so I don't want to forget anything, and that would be even more lame. This is not how the lights will be for the whole show. I know this looks ugly, but it's okay. It'll look better, I promise. Thank you so much for coming. It means so much to me and the students and the fine arts department all together that you're going to come and see all the hard work that we've been putting into this actually pay off. This is our first non-chapel performance of the year, and because of the reshuffling, it's normally you go from chapel to the one acts, and then later in the year you do the full-length production. This year we went from chapel like right into the big one. So big learning curve for me, big learning curve for building things because of a little change we had in our stage. So we're happy that it all came together, and I think you're really going to have a good time. Housekeeping things, phones, no noisy phones, please. We do everything we can to make this gym like a theater. So all we ask in return is that you act like you're at a theater. Mute your phone, go nuts and turn it off for a couple hours or something. If you're gonna take pictures, try not to hold that like 7-foot screen on your phone up in front of everyone for like 5 minutes at a time, and no flash, because that's kind of distracting for the actors. Blah, blah, blah. There's gonna be two short intermissions, because we have tonight two plays, a short curtain raiser and then our full-length play. And the full-length play aired on the side of short, so we had a chance to do a little something else that I think you're really gonna enjoy. So there should be like a 10 to 15 intermission after the first little play ends, and then a shorter one, 5 to 10 minutes between acts of the full-length play. So you have time to stretch your legs a little bit, go grab a snack, a water, go to the bathroom, do whatever you gotta do. There will be no meandering, begging children during intermission this time, but it has been brought to my attention that there's probably some people who want to make a special donation to the drama department, and we really, really appreciate that. We encourage that. You can do it to the snack bar folks at either intermission. They'll happily take all of your money, all of it, okay? So now that I got through all the boring stuff, a couple things. Our feature presentation tonight, our full-length play, is called A Fly on the Wall. It is by a playwright called Pat Cook, which we've done his stuff at Brienne before. He writes for high schoolers, but he writes really smart for high schoolers. So I think you're going to appreciate how funny it is, but also how it's not all lowbrow humor. Some of it is recurring jokes and interesting things that you'll see kind of layer on top of each other. It's a fun mystery story. Please relax a little bit. It's okay to laugh and cackle if appropriate. If you're a student here and you haven't been to a production before, or not a lot of them, we try not to make it like, oh, Jimmy's on stage. Jimmy! Every time, you know, or anything crazy like that. So if you were at a playhouse somewhere and a really famous, like, you know, Christopher Walken walked on stage, you wouldn't be like, Christopher! So just, you know, similar etiquette. That's the full-length play. I think you're really going to like it. Our first story tonight, I think, requires a little bit more introduction because it's a little weird. We kind of went back and forth for a while. We knew what we were going to do for the full-length play, and then we were like, man, that's short. That's, like, really short for a full-length play. So we're going to do something short before it. So we read through probably 4 different scripts. Didn't dislike any of them, but the moment the kids got to this one, they decided that's the one. And it's, I would say, the most challenging choice of everything we read. It's the most ambitious for the actors because you're going to see from the first play to the full-length play, you're going to see a crazy amount of range out of these kids. We go from one sort of tone and one sort of story to a completely different genre of storytelling and play altogether. So you're going to see people who look like normal people and then they do not anymore. And the other way around, this person looks like a lunatic and now they look normal. So appreciate that as you see it unfold before you. The Twilight Zone, how many of you are familiar with The Twilight Zone in some capacity? Okay, good. This is a play, short play that's adapted from a Twilight Zone story. I love The Twilight Zone, and important thing to know about The Twilight Zone is that it's 1960, 1963, somewhere in there, the second season of The Twilight Zone, which started in like 1959. So this aired somewhere in that couple year range. The climate, the social climate and the attitude and the culture and everything that was very different, as some of you well know, because you experienced it. I'm 25, so I didn't. But the Cold War was a thing. Paranoia was a thing. Not being sure about whether Russia was going to invade the next day was a very real threat to people. And that, with the kind of special concoction of space becoming a huge part of culture and the space race, and everybody became obsessed with space. You look at all of the horror films and all of the kind of thrillers, they're all giant aliens or bugs from outer space or whatever. That's all part of the social consciousness. So between those two things, they sort of had a baby, and out came the Twilight Zone. And it's all these anthology stories that are all different from episode to episode, but you get those themes kind of interwoven throughout. So keep that in mind when you see it unfold, that there's a lot of that kind of thread beating through it. I think you're going to really like this stuff. Please, at the conclusion of the first play and at the end of the second play, let the kids know how much you appreciated it. They put in a ton of hard work. It's one of the hardest working group of kids I've seen, and enjoy the show.
This is 1183A. I repeat, 1183A. Responding to a call about an unidentified flying object that supposedly landed somewhere in Hook's Landing. Appears something cut off the top of some trees and landed in the ice at Tracy's Pond. I can't see it now. Maybe a meteor or something? Whatever it is, it'll be under the ice until next spring.
What do you say? How's it look?
I can't say for now.
All right, Paget. Hey, there's some talk of a bridge going out up there. When you can, you better take a look and make sure it's posted and blocked off. Supposedly there's enough ice jammed up against it to cool the Congo.
Roger that. Footprints. Looks like they lead away from the pond and up toward a diner. Looks like there's a bus parked out front.
You don't suppose it came out of that pond, do you?
Very funny. I'm gonna follow these tracks to make sure they lead to the diner. I'll call you back.
Wintry February night. The present. Order of events. A phone call from a frightened woman notating the arrival of an unidentified flying object. And the checkout you've just witnessed with a state trooper verifying the event. But with nothing more enlightening to add beyond evidence of some tracks leading across the highway to a diner. You've heard trying to find a needle in a haystack is hard? Well, in a minute, you'll search with him, because you've just landed in the Twilight Zone.
Thank you. officer.
Whose bus is parked out front?
That's mine, officer. What's the problem?
Bridge up ahead has been declared temporarily impassable. Ice flow stacked up against it, and another pound of weight could turn the entire thing into driftwood.
That's rough. Can't turn around and go back. There's a slide up at the turnaround. Blocked the whole road.
Looks like you're stuck.
Yep.
Till morning, anyways.
Till morning? I have a meeting in Boston at 9 a.m.
Well, then you better lace up your snowshoes and start walking, mister, because that bus stays out there till they fix the bridge.
Might as well get comfortable and get a little hot food in you.
A little hot food? That's great. That's just fine. That's precious little consolation for missing my meeting in Boston. That's a fine little bus line you work for, isn't it, mister? They care so much about their schedules, don't they?
I wouldn't be too hard on them, mister. They ain't got no control over the snow, the bridges, the sides of hills that decide to come down. It's pretty much out of their hands.
What's the trouble, officer? Are you looking for someone?
You got a passenger manifest?
Passenger manifest? What do you think I got parked out there, 707? Nah, that's a 14-year-old bus and business is lousy. My boss would run rum across the border if there was a profit in it. We don't ask passengers their names. We just smile and help them in. We're happy to have them, with or without names.
Know you how many you had?
4. Unless one of them flew out the window when we hit a bump. Picked up 4 and is supposed to deliver 4.
No one flew out. Someone must have jumped in. There's 5 here now.
That's funny. I know I had 4 people.
Thank you. Now, tell me, was anybody here before the bus stopped?
No, I haven't had anyone in here since 11 o'clock this morning. I just figured that this whole lot got off the bus together.
We did. There was no one here when we came in.
Then how do you account for 5 people?
That one beats me. Unless one of them didn't get off the bus.
Which one of you wasn't on the bus?
We were all on the bus. What kind of interrogation is this? If I'm gonna get grilled, I want a lawyer.
Oh, that's funny. First you want snowshoes, then you want a lawyer.
You know, I didn't see you on the bus.
That's funny. I didn't see you neither. Makes one of us a liar now, don't it?
What is this, a diner or the Gestapo headquarters?
Now, take it easy, mister. What's all of this fuss about?
You heard something fly over recently?
Fly over here? No, I haven't heard anything.
Got a call about an hour ago. Woman said she heard something fly over and land.
Fly over here? From where?
Up there. An unidentified flying object.
An unidentified flying object? Sorry, officer. Nothing has come down from up there except for snow. That is all I have seen for the past 14 hours, snow. Where'd she say it came down, anyways?
Tracy's Pond. Found a trail of broken branches before it hit. Found tracks leading away from it.
To where?
Here.
You're telling me that something landed in Tracy's Pond and then made its way into here? That's crazy. Nothing has been in here since 11 o'clock this morning. Nothing except for...
Except for me and my passengers. Me and 4 people. I mean, it's a 1 person here.
George, I don't like this.
Easy, honey. Easy. Let me get this straight. You're trying to tell me that someone in here landed in some kind of a saucer or something and came in here?
Came in here. With us?
That's impossible. We would have seen them.
Well, we did get off that bus with our eyes closed to get out of the snow. Someone could have joined and we might not have noticed.
Well, it seems to me you people should know who was on the bus with you.
I wouldn't be too sure about that. They did load up in some pretty thick snow down at Hook's Landing. Tell you the truth, I don't know exactly who got on.
She's a real science fiction, ain't she? A regular Ray Bradbury. 4 humans and 1 monster from outer space. You wouldn't happen to have an eye in the back of your head now, would ya?
I find you offensive. You know that?
What'd you do now, officer?
Well, this isn't exactly par for the course. Had some nutty assignments, but this one...
Well, I know how you start. Eliminate the couple. You came in here looking for one person, you can eliminate the couple.
We're exonerated. Cross us off, we're two of the humans. What's the matter, honey?
It's just... I could have sworn you had a mole on your chin.
A mole on my chin? Connie, I've never had a mole on my chin. I can tell you how this is going to happen. We're all gonna get so panicky that everyone's gonna start picking up little invisible clues from everybody else. This is nonsense.
You're right. This is nonsense. If a husband and wife start wondering whether the husband is really the husband and the wife is really...
Connie! I think that 23 years is long enough for a woman to know who she's married to. And I'll thank you to stop looking at me like I put this face on as some part of a costume.
Oh, I love this! He don't know who she is, she don't know who he is, we don't know who she is, and this lemon sucker over here, well, you're the most suspicious of the bunch!
Lemon sucker.
Got a back door to this place?
Sure, why?
Go ahead and lock it.
It's already locked. But if that thing really is from outer space, it could probably just crawl through the walls anyways.
Check them for wings! Check them for wings! Look under their coats!
Got identification, Grandma?
Nope. Left it down at the pond. In my spaceship!
Hey! Who won the World Series last year?
What sort of prolonged practical joke is this?
That's a puzzler. I got it. Pirates won it. Took 4 out of 7 from the Yankees. But you didn't figure us Martians knew nothing about the great American pastime now, did you? Oh, we did.
What about you, miss? You have identification?
Well, as a matter of fact, no, I don't. I left it in my suitcase. It was shipped on ahead.
Got a name?
Ethel McConnell. I'm a ballet dancer.
Check her legs. Count them. How many legs does she got?
She was on the bus.
How do you know?
She's the only one I noticed.
Thank you.
But what about you? Hmm? How do we know you were the same one driving the bus?
You don't?
Well, then ain't nobody been exonerated yet, that's for sure.
Look, let's just cut this farce out right now. We'll all just show our identifications and get this thing over with. It's ridiculous.
Then how do you explain the extra person?
Yes, how about that?
Simple. The driver is mistaken. 5 people got on the bus, and he thought there were only 4.
Is this possible?
Oh, not a chance in the world. I counted heads before we took off. There were 4 people.
Out walking after men.
What was that?
Well, we might get a laugh out of this in the morning, but in the meantime, everyone stays right where they are.
Trooper?
I stepped outside. Snow stopped. Say, Cheryl, that wasn't your gag, was it? In the whole business with the jukebox setting like that?
Not me, no. If a jukebox is a jukebox, and if that thing wants to start up all by itself, then you have to call an electrician.
No! I got an idea! Watch this, Twinkle Toes! Take me to your leader. Take me to your leader!
No answer.
Peculiar.
Find anything?
Well, I checked out the bridge. It seems to be holding together all right.
I know that bridge, and what's more, I don't like it.
Well, thank goodness we needn't concern ourselves with your judgment. You know, if that bridge gets a fine, clean bill of health, you have to drive us right across it.
Look, mister, you may be a big shot in Boston, but when it comes to buses and bridges, I got seniority. And I can tell you, that bridge is so old that at any time...
Hey, what is this? What? Why did the lights just turn off like that?
We may be losing power.
This is weird. This is just plain weird.
And as I still hold on, I think of the things we've done.
Well, I wish whoever this is would just play his cards now. You know, what exactly is the point of us all just staying cooped up in here instead of going out and...
Well, the point is this, ma'am. We're all kids in the closet here. No one understands what's going on. Listen, if a saucer did land and someone or something did sneak in here with you, I think it'd be a good idea to pinpoint that individual and keep him from leaving.
It makes sense. Maybe this thing is just... invisible, and it's messing around, like cat and mouse.
This is childish nonsense.
Well, it's as good as any idea that I've heard. And what if this thing doesn't show itself? Are we just gonna sit here holding our breaths?
Yes, how about that?
Well, if you ask me, I...
Well, no one did ask.
Why don't you leave the poor woman alone?
Who invited you into this?
Well, I didn't realize we were waiting for invitations, but you, sir, I've got this big thing about bossing everybody around.
Look, it's hard enough just sitting around in here without becoming some sort of...
Oh, my gosh.
Now everybody sit down.
Hello? What's that? All right. Thank you. The bridge has just been checked. It's okay.
Well, it's about time.
I suppose I can't hold you people here on a set of footprints I found in the snow. You're free to leave. Travel safe now.
You're making a big mistake, officer. Big mistake. You're letting the monster out.
It may well be, ma'am. It may well be. You can't hold somebody on suspicion of being a monster. You're good to roll anytime.
All right. But are they sure about that bridge? I don't trust that sucker. She swings in the wind and she's not a suspension.
That was the county engineer. The bridge has officially been deemed passable. I'll cross on ahead of you first.
All right, folks, you can come and pay your checks right over here. Thank you. And y'all come back. That is all but one of you. You got the chili. That'll be 90 cents.
Well, I have 50.
All right. And you got, what, about 14 cups of coffee? That's $1.40. Thank you, sir. Here, keep the change. Oh, thank you. Officer Padgett?
Miss McConnell?
Well, I counted 5.
That's right. 5.
Betcha by the time we get back to Boston, there'll be 17!
All right. You take it nice and easy across that bridge and keep an eye on your rear view mirror.
Keep your head down.
Thank you.
Something for you?
Coffee. Black.
Sure thing. Coffee. Black. Here you are, mister. Hey, wait a second. Didn't you... What I mean to say is, weren't you one of the ones who went off on that bus earlier?
Yes. Indeed, I went out on that bus. And you know something? That bridge wasn't safe. It collapsed. The state police car, the bus, everything. Kerplunk, right into the river. It was a terrible scene. No one got out.
Except you.
Except me. Just lucky, I guess.
Very lucky. But you...
But what?
But you're not even wet.
Wet? What's wet?
What do you mean, what's wet? You said that you fell into the river, but your clothes are all dry.
An illusion. It's all just an illusion, that's all. Like that jukebox playing in the corner? That's an illusion, too. Or that telephone ringing. Just an illusion.
What are you? Some kind of magician?
Who, me? Hardly. Now, before you faint, dead away, I ought to explain. The name isn't really Roth. And I wasn't really going to Boston. I was sent as more of an advanced scout. This black coffee tastes wonderful. We haven't got a thing like it where I come from. My friends will be arriving shortly. I think they're gonna like it here. It's so remote, so pleasant, so off the beaten track. Perfect spot for a colony, don't you think, Cheryl? Now, while we're waiting, how about a little, what's the word? Music. Oh well. More coffee for me, I suppose.
Incident in a northeastern winter. To be believed or disbelieved. As it turned out, Trooper Paget had plenty of reason to hold on to his suspects. Speaking of holding on to things, if a sour-faced businessman named Ross ever shows up on your premises, you'd be best not to shake his hand. Or hands. Because that very man may just try to pull you into the Twilight Zone.
Walking after midnight out in the moonlight, just like we used to do. I'm always walking after midnight, searching for you.
I walk for my... All right. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. Enjoy a brief intermission, and we'll reset and see you back here in 15.
fly on the wall.
Do what?
That's it, a fly on the wall.
Mrs. Starling, I ask you to come up with a sentence to best describe what you think of yourself, and that's what you come up with?
That's it. I'm crazy, right?
No, you're not crazy. And I've told you so many times before, we don't use that word.
What about loco?
No.
Nuts, bonkers, missing some shingles. Pick one.
Look, you just have a very vivid imagination, that's all.
You keep saying that, Dr. Axelrod. You really think I'm making all of this up?
I didn't say that. I simply believe you tend to exaggerate a bit.
I'm not exaggerating anything. Everything I've told you has all been true.
Really? You've been my patient for almost 3 months now, and so far you've told me that you've met the men in black, you were abducted by UFOs, and you used to date Nicolas Cage.
See what I mean? I'm always seeing those things. Nobody else, just me. And nobody will believe me, not even my shrink.
And that's another word I've politely asked you not to use.
You don't have much of a social life, do you?
We're not here to talk about me.
Oh, hit a nerve, did I?
What?
I mean, when I said that, you jumped up.
I didn't jump up, and it wasn't because of anything you said. My pen simply ran out of ink. And judging by your notes, you can understand why. Mrs. Starling!
Then you deny it!
Why are you so interested?
Oh, good one. Turn it around. Back to me.
And you didn't answer that question now, did you?
Well...
You have this daughter?
I have this daughter. Say, you really are good.
Not married, right?
Wow, you should work at a carnival, set up a tent, get into this crystal ball.
Is that why you've been coming to see me all this time?
No, I was just thinking, since you were in the market, and I have this item I've been trying to get off the shelf.
So you made up all these stories just to give you an excuse?
I didn't make up anything. Everything I've told you has all been true. Dating Nicolas Cage, the UFOs, the elephant in my backyard.
Wait. What elephant?
I didn't tell you about that. Listen, the other day I found these enormous footprints in my petunias, and they were just...
So sorry to disturb Dr. Axelrod, but the delivery people are here.
Miss Burton, how many times have I told you I cannot be disturbed when I'm with a patient?
Who's also disturbed. I'm not supposed to say that word either, am I?
But they must leave your terrarium because they're on a very tight schedule.
Oh, very well, let them in. Mm-hmm. I have a tight schedule too, you know.
Talking to yourself, doctor. Wonder what that's a sign of.
It's perfectly normal. Everybody does it.
Everybody who doesn't have a social life.
Mrs. Starling, I know why you're doing this.
Because I'm cuckoo.
No. That's...
This way.
All right. Let's get this hang in here.
Well, where do you want this thing?
Bring it over here, against this wall.
All right, and what? 1, 2, 3, 4, hut, 2,
he's putting in an aquarium?
It's not aquarium, it's terrarium.
Does it know it's a terrarium? Because it's acting a lot like an aquarium.
Is that good?
Fine, that's fine. Now if you'll let me get back to my practice...
Hold up, Doc. Paperwork.
What?
Part of our regs. Need your John Hancock on this.
Oh, yes, whatever.
Seems a little edgy today.
Only today.
Maybe he should go out and relax a little, say, on a date.
There, now...
Wait a sec. You gotta sign here in the middle, too.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
And since you mentioned it, is he seeing anyone?
He claimed to have fiancé, but I never seen her.
Mm-hmm.
Now can I...
Wait! You need to sign here, put your initials here. Here, sign here, initials, signature, initials, signature, signature. I'll write that down, sir.
I'm trying to.
When are you gonna put the water in this thing?
It's not an aquarium, it's a terrarium.
Huh?
It's not for fish, it's for plants.
You bought a box for plants?
Yes.
Well, then you have to put water in it sometime, duh.
I suppose so. There. Now, is that all?
Thank you very much. What's in there?
That's my restroom. Do you mind?
I was looking for one of those. Do you mind?
Oh, what next? Go on, be my guest.
Thank you.
Ahem.
Sorry. I can't leave you because he's my ride.
Da!
Doc, you gotta help me. Everyone keeps watching me. Everyone's against me.
Hi.
And it's not just people either, Doc. They ain't from this world, I tell ya. They're from Mars.
You see them too?
Ty, I am with a patient.
Oh, sorry.
Are you out of your mind?
You're in the right place.
Mrs. Starling, there's nothing wrong with him. He's just an ad man who works on the third floor who thinks he's funny.
And you say there's nothing wrong with him?
Ty, you know better than to come bursting in on me when I'm with a patient.
Hey, how was I supposed to know the door was open?
What? Miss Burton!
I'm sorry. Oh, Miss Ferguson!
Dr. Axelrod, sorry to have just dropped in unannounced like this, but since I saw the door open...
Yes, I'm thinking of opening up a hot dog stand.
I said I was sorry. Jeez, man, you're starting to sound like you have a persecution complex or something.
This comes from a man who spells socks with an X. Now, Mrs. Dirksen, what is so important that you couldn't tell me over the phone?
That's just it. You never know who's listening in.
Oh, Mrs. Dirksen, not you too.
This isn't just idle paranoia.
Yes, I know. It sounds like it's been very busy.
Well, when I heard from who I heard from, I thought I'd better tell you in person.
And just who did you hear from?
The police, asking about you.
Me?
We weren't listening, really. No, we weren't listening, but I think your fish are dead!
That's a terrarium.
What did they want to know about me?
Well, when they called, they asked about your tenants, and then when I mentioned you, I mentioned your practice and your patients.
My patients?
Did I ever mention I was involved in a bank robbery?
Mrs. Starling, I'll get back to our session as soon as I can.
Oh, I can't wait.
Yeah, me neither.
You won't be here. What about my patients?
What did she say about a bank robbery?
Oh, pay her no attention. She's trying to get me to date her daughter.
Of all the nerve.
I know.
And you won't even meet my daughter.
Mrs. Dirksen, the police, what did they say?
Well, they wouldn't mention anyone specifically, but they said they'd be contacting you personally.
Miss Burton?
You haven't received any phone call from police.
You mean while you've been in here?
Oh yeah, I didn't think of it.
All right, Mac, time to hit the road.
Hang on.
Wait.
Well, I thought I'd tell you before they got here.
They said they're coming here. When?
Excuse me, I'm Lieutenant Diana Palmer with the 12th Precinct. I bet that's them now.
You think?
Hold it. Let me handle this.
Ty.
Excuse me, but you're the police, right?
Didn't I just say that?
May I see your search warrant?
I'm not searching anything.
Then what are you doing here?
Just here to ask a few questions.
Greg, that's why I didn't want to leave.
I see.
Yeah.
Ty, this is no time
to... No. Wait. Don't you need some kind of warrant to ask questions?
No, we usually just need permission, usually verbal, from the person being interviewed. Trust me. I know the law. I'm a law officer.
A detective?
Yes.
Well, let's just see about that.
Ty, what do you think you're doing?
Let's see how good you are.
How?
Detective.
What is this, a pop quiz?
One of us here is a psychiatrist. Which one?
I don't care.
You don't care? Why don't you care?
You're the psychiatrist.
She's good.
Don't mind him. He has delusions of adequacy. Mm. Now, officer, may I ask what this is all about? Why do you need to ask me any questions?
You're used to being on the other end of that. I mean, you're the one who usually asks the questions, right?
Well, of course I ask questions. It's how I make my diagnoses.
And that's what I do, ask questions. However, I need to speak with you someplace privately.
Well, this used to be private.
Right, yeah, private.
Terrarium.
Uh-huh. Where you hold your sessions, is that what you call them?
Ah, you don't like psychiatrists, do you? Oh,
say, you are good. You think I'm bad, you should hear my captain. Look, you have patients who come to you. Sometimes for years, and somewhere along the way, you tell them that they have something only you can pronounce. Something in Latin.
Oh, you mean like modus operandi?
Oh, touche. You have them relax on that fancy couch there, show them pictures of ink spots.
Ink blots.
Spots, blots, what's the difference?
Well, the ink blots are part of the accredited Rorschach test. The ink spots sang Stompin' at the Savoy.
I stand corrected. Now, if we may continue with my questions?
We can. If we could have some privacy.
Right, yeah, privacy. Right. Would you like me to clear the room?
Are you going to use your gun?
No, don't have one. The idea is to make them want to leave. Watch this. As a matter of fact, I am just thrilled you all are here today. You see, I'm investigating an income tax fraud case, and I'm going to be having some IRS auditors here.
Right, yeah.
Tight schedule.
I gotta get through the door.
Thought that might do the trick.
Nice trick.
Yes, but that is until they realize tax fraud is federal and I'm local, but that crowd, they'll never figure it out.
Honestly.
No, Dr. Axelrod, what should
Mrs. Starling, I am so sorry about all this. Miss Burton, please reschedule her for another appointment as soon as possible, please.
Of course, Miss Starling.
I'm sure I'll have lots more to tell you.
I have no doubt. Miss Burton? The door?
Just about to tend to that. I only have two hands. I forget one little thing, and that's what he grinds on.
Now, what's this all about?
The long and the short of it, we're trying to locate a certain person.
And just who might that be?
I'm not at liberty to divulge that information.
Oh, so I'm on a you-don't-need-to-know basis. Now see here, officer. I can't have some ham-fisted investigation taking weeks on end and frightening my patients.
Ham-fisted?
Running down profiles and putting my patients through lineups and things like that.
Profiles? Lineups?
Oh, whatever you people say in cases like this one.
Uh-huh. Nice terrarium.
Huh. Lucky guess.
I see you have several African violets in there among the creeping figs. We're not all just mugshots and APBs, you know.
I must admit, I'm impressed.
As I was saying, we're trying to locate a particular individual, so if you could give us a list of your clients, that would be most...
Uh-huh. Now this is exactly what I was expecting. Now see here, officer.
Wait. I believe I know exactly how our conversation will go. I say I need to see a list of your patients, and you come back with how impossible that would be. I say, but this is vital to our investigation, and you say, your hands are tied. Then I come back with how you could be withholding what is possible evidence, and you cite doctor-patient confidentiality, something like that.
I hope I wasn't too tough on you.
That's always the clincher, isn't it? Doctor-patient confidentiality.
Which any doctor worth his oath holds sacred. Look, we don't read crystal balls or read the bumps on patients' foreheads. We listen to my patient's symptoms and determine whether those are a result of psychiatric illness, physical illness, or a combination of both. We work hand in hand with the medical profession. So you can see I'm not just all couches and ink spots.
Can't you tell me anything about your caseload?
Can't you tell me anything about who you're looking for?
I was afraid you'd catch that particular irony. Oh, excuse me, won't you?
Oh, by all means.
Palmer here? What? I'm at his office now. Oh, we're getting along like family. What? Now? I could be there in 20 minutes.
Hold it. What are you doing?
Okay, I'm on my way now. Should be back in about an hour.
Oh, I'll think about you while you're gone.
Yes, Lieutenant?
Officer Thurlow, I'm headed back to the station house and I need you to stay here.
You can count on me.
Wait a minute there. What are you doing?
No, I don't want to miss anything or anyone. It's for your own good, whether you believe it or not.
Ain't nobody getting past me either coming or going.
His name's Calvin Thurlow. Just don't make any sudden moves. Tends to make him nervous.
What kind of a police officer?
I'll be back as soon as I can.
That's Birdcage.
So, how are you?
Along with his one-man band.
And then there I was. Only 8 years old when all the other kids ran away from me. Mm-hmm. And the way that they looked at me, you know, like I was some kind of monster. Just because I was bigger than them.
Now, you know children can be very cruel at times.
But I just wanted to play with them, you know, like everybody else. I didn't mean to sit on that seesaw so hard. I just plopped on my end, and the next thing I know, Charlie Frobisher went straight through the monkey bars.
Yes, I understand, but you can't let that nag at you. That was a long time ago. Remember how I told you about your happy place, where you go whenever you feel like that?
Out in the woods. And it's summer?
That's right. Can you see it now?
Yes. Yes, I can.
Now, doesn't that make you relax and feel better?
Uh-huh. Can you tell me about the rabbits again?
All the rabbits and deer and other creatures of the forest come up to you.
And they eat right out of my hand?
That's right. And they're not afraid of you, are they?
Oh, it's so beautiful.
Now you just remember, that's your happy place and you can go there anytime you like.
Well, I do need a break, you know. This job has a lot of stress.
Oh, I can imagine. Especially with this case you're working on right now, right?
Oh, you said a mouthful. Mm-hmm. It's always the worst when we're trying to catch a killer.
Yes, I guess so.
What's the matter?
Oh, nothing. I was just going to my happy place.
No, I have to check with Dr. Axelrod first.
No,
I probably shouldn't.
Why?
Officer Thurlow!
I wasn't doing nothing!
Get on your feet! What is the meaning of this?
We were just talking.
I asked the officer. Well?
I was thinking about getting a new couch for the apartment, and the doctor here said I could just try out his, so I...
Don't even try. Well, what did he tell you?
I told you before. Doctor-patient confidentiality.
He is not your patient.
Now just what do you want from me?
I told you, I need to know about your patients, like that tiny lady who was here earlier.
Emma Starling? You can't suspect her of anything.
It might surprise you who I suspect.
Well then why didn't you question her while she was here?
I'm trying to keep this investigation on a low profile. I don't want to scare off anyone who might have valuable information later.
Well, she's been coming to me for several months, and I can tell you for a fact she's no killer.
Killer? Officer Thurlow?
I better go call Captain Mulroney, check in, you know.
You do that. And I'll be sure to say a few words to her about you when we get back to the station house.
I thought you might. Happy place!
Miss Burton?
I'm leaving. And closing door behind me.
Practice that, why don't you?
Doesn't have to get sarcastic.
Now, just in case you are wondering, here is my badge, number 717. These are my credentials. Would you also like to see my driver's license or birth certificate?
What are you talking about? I never doubted who you said you were.
Yeah? Then how come you called my captain?
What?
And complained about how I was bulldozing everybody around. That's just what she told me in her office a few minutes ago in no uncertain terms.
How could I phone anybody in the room right here with me from the with Calvin in the room right here with me from the moment you left?
You didn't call anyone while I was gone.
No.
What is this that I am hearing about the police putting you under some kind of an investigation?
Mom.
Mrs. Axelrod, I was just trying to
your
tell
you. Your mother? What did you do now? And don't lie to me because you know I can always tell!
Let me in on it when you catch him. Who are you? Lieutenant Diana Palmer. Like to see my credentials?
I just know that your father is turning over in his grave right now!
Dad was cremated.
The police!
I suppose you didn't call her either.
I didn't!
Oh, she just made a lucky guess then.
Him? He didn't call me!
Well, then there's no way you could... Miss Burton?
It was me.
What? You called her? Who told you to do that? I certainly didn't, and I'm the one who gives you a paycheck every week.
Well, so does she.
What?
I report into her every week and tell her what you've been doing and the like.
My own mother pays you to spy on me!
Well, you never called.
Spying.
So it was you who called my captain?
No.
Miss Burton?
I didn't! She don't pay me!
She's the only one in the room who doesn't!
Yo, Phil, what the cops catch you with?
Oh, they're still here?
What do you want now?
Wow, try to show a little sympathy and see what it gets you.
How many times have I told you not to come bursting into my office?
Door was open.
Miss Burton!
Oh, no.
I swear I am going to nail that thing shut!
I'll get it!
So tell me, Philly, what did you do?
Mom, I told you, I didn't do anything.
Then why is she here?
I'm trying to find somebody.
Who?
Good luck with that one.
I'm not at liberty to say.
Can you give us a hint?
No.
Has this person been in the newspapers recently?
I wouldn't know.
What about on television? Is it a congressman? Oh, those congressmen are always pulling something illegal.
I can't say.
Just give me his initials. Is it a man or a woman?
What?
She loves game shows.
You know, my son Philly here has had quite a few congressmen on that couch.
What? What congressman have you had on the couch?
I'm not going to tell her, I'm going to tell you.
Officer Thurlow!
Here!
You were supposed to be phoning Captain Mulroney.
I can't right now. I lost my cell phone.
What?
It must have fallen out when I was lying down here.
Which you shouldn't have been doing in the first place.
Excuse me, who are you?
Shh! So just... tell me, is it a senator or a congressman?
Mom, would you stop? They're trying to catch some killer.
What?
Which you didn't hear from me.
My son is not a killer. Heck, he won't even kill a spider when he's at home because he always makes me do it.
Mom.
You live with your mother?
She lives with me. When Dad died, I moved her in, and I don't know why I'm telling you all this.
Ah, he is the little devil.
Great. Now report in.
All right.
Mom, all the officer is trying to do is ask a few questions. I'm not a suspect. Am I?
Yeah. Is he?
Hello? Officer Thurlow, here with Lieutenant Palmer.
I can't tell you anything about the case.
What kind of questions do you want to ask my son?
What did I just say?
I asked you a question. Who are you?
Yes. Where did you come from?
Me? Channel 6 News.
What?
Yeah, I'm here with the psychiatrist, his secretary, his mother.
You're a reporter.
And some reporter. I don't know, she just showed up.
Kelly Dorsett.
How did you hear about this case?
We got a call in the newsroom.
What, is someone phoning everybody in the phone book?
I didn't call her either.
I didn't say you did.
Yeah, but you were thinking it.
Who called you?
I can't divulge my sources.
Ugh. You won't talk, he won't talk.
And you won't talk either, let's not forget.
Hopefully loud in here for all you people not talking. Sorry. What? Okay, I'll tell him.
All right, I have had enough. I need everybody to leave this room, and I mean now.
What?
You heard me. I need to question the shrink in private, which is what I came here to do hours ago.
But I'm his mother!
I'm sorry, ma'am, but this is a police investigation, so I'm going to need you to leave the room immediately. I do hope you can understand that.
Well, isn't she nice?
Oh, Lieutenant?
What?!
I just got off the phone with Captain Mulroney. She said she's coming over.
What? She's coming here?
Uh-huh. And she said that nobody can leave. Well, you told me to report in!
Thank you.
Okay. We'll give a better report.
Okay.
There! As I was saying, Captain Mulroney does not have time for all of this.
Now then, let's try to get a few things straightened up here. But first things first, where did you get that whistle?
Oh, this little thing? I referee at my kids' basketball games. I'm sorry.
No need to apologize, Officer Thurlow. I was thinking of reinstating it as part of our standard equipment. It reminds me of those old-style traffic cops.
I must apologize a little myself, Captain Mulroney. I didn't mean for you to get dragged into all of this, but you can see what I'm up against here. Trying to make sense of this crowd?
Oh, I think I have the gist of everyone's complaints here. She keeps his office in order and is worried all this will be blamed on her.
Yes.
He is in advertising and just happened to be here when this all took place.
That's right.
You don't believe you could be a suspect?
Hey, I'm an ad man. I don't believe in anything. Unless they pay me.
You're just not funny. She is a reporter who received a call about this investigation and refuses to reveal her sources.
That's right, and I refuse to... You just said that.
She is the mother of the psychiatrist who won't hear anything against him unless it's the occasional phone call.
Huh, you could say that again. Wait, did I say that?
No, but you're his mother, and why else would you be here? And you are the psychiatrist who stands behind his oath of doctor-patient confidentiality, right?
As I've said so many times already.
And Diana, you are the officer leading the investigation. Tell me, what have you learned so far?
So far, not much of anything. I haven't been able to ask a single question.
So it appears I'm all caught up. Well, I have one thing to tell you all. Someone in this room is the murderer.
What?
I was just kidding. Honestly, I have wanted to do that since day one. Been on the force for over 30 years, never had the chance. Just trying to show you we're not all brute force around here, handling things in a ham-fisted sort of way.
And to think I called you to complain about her?
What? You called her?
Yeah, tell them it's some sort of tax fraud case? That's federal. And you're local!
Ugh, that was just to... clearing the room, that's all I was doing.
I told you it wasn't me who called.
So, is this a murder investigation?
Not this investigation, no.
Then this has nothing to do with the other psychiatrists who have been murdered?
What? What?
I didn't say that.
Yeah, I've heard of them.
You think you could have mentioned that to me? Or were you too busy phoning up people?
So this does have to do with those murders.
I didn't say that either.
Other psychiatrists have been murdered?
Oh, hon, do try and keep up.
So it was you who called that reporter?
Me? I haven't even heard of her.
Well, after I get the scoop, I'm sure you will be hearing about me. So tell me about this investigation.
I can tell you two things.
Mm-hmm.
Number one, we're contacting every psychiatrist in the city.
Okay. And?
And everything we say here will be off the record. And you know what that means.
Yes, I do.
Why didn't I think of that?
You're still learning, Diana.
This isn't my first investigation, you know, respectfully speaking.
I know. You're the youngest person ever to make your grade. Now, I need to speak only to my lieutenant and to Dr. Axelrod. Officer Thurlow?
All right, everybody out, let's go. Come on, show's over.
But I'm his mother!
I will call you personally and let you know if we find out anything.
Huh, sure.
She calls me!
Great, you're a member of a family, you get in the loop. But working for the press? Forget it.
Come on, let's go. Come on, Ed, man. Out.
Oh, goodness. Miss Burton, you might as well go out to lunch now.
Yes, sir.
Again, Captain Mulroney, I am so sorry you had to get dragged into
all... Now, what seems to be the problem with you two?
Us?
She doesn't seem to understand my position in regards to my patients.
No, he doesn't seem to understand. I'm doing this all for his benefit.
You keep saying that, but you won't tell me anything.
And neither will you.
So you can have your reasons for keeping quiet, but I can't?
I have my regs to follow.
So do I.
Part of my job is public relations.
What?
I'll show you what I mean. Diana, you can't just barge in here and demand their cooperation, you know.
That's right.
You can give the whole force a black eye that way.
I was just...
And I won't stand for any bullying on my watch.
I wouldn't exactly say she's bullying.
And you.
Here, you're just being stupid.
Stupid? Me?
Ma'am, I wouldn't exactly call him stupid, respectfully speaking.
What would you call him, then?
He's just trying to look out for the better interests of his patients.
That's right. Thank you. And she hasn't really been all that forceful. Just trying to ask a few questions is all.
So you won't be filing any complaints, then?
Complaints? Certainly not. Never entered my mind.
And you think he's in his rights, then?
I never said otherwise.
So I can count on you two to work together from now on.
Right.
Of course.
Then it appears my work here is done. Officer Thurlow?
What?
Let us depart the premises.
Whatever you say, Captain.
What just happened here?
Not sure, but I think it was psychological.
I was just going to say that.
You were?
Mm-hmm. I think this place is starting to rub off on me.
Notice the improvement?
Hmm. What do you say we just start over?
That's what I would call a sound idea.
Well, you would know. You're the psychiatrist. Tell you what, how about I buy you lunch, just to cement relations?
Oh, that's very kind of you, but unfortunately I already have a lunch date, which I think I'm late for.
Understood. We'll take this up later?
I look forward to it. I just hope she hasn't been waiting too long. She's already on the warpath about me always running late and... Hi, hon. No, listen, I got held up and... No, really, it's not an excuse. Well, if you'll just let me explain, you would not believe the day I've been having here. No, nothing to do with one of my patients. Well, it might be, though. Listen, it's a long story. Why don't you just let me explain when I get there? Just a second, hon. Yes?
Dr. Axelrod?
You can't be my next appointment. This is my lunch hour.
No, I don't have an appointment. I just need to speak to you.
I understand, but now is simply not a good time. I'm leaving right now.
But this is important!
I said I can't. I'm on my way.
Dr. Axelrod?
What? What are you doing?
As I said, I really need to speak to you. And I mean now!
So I see. Hon, I may be a little later than I thought.
Oh, this shouldn't take too long.
No. Take all the time you need. How can I help you?
Oh, that's what you all say, all you psychiatrists, isn't it?
Oh, I suppose so. It's our job.
Fine. There's nobody else here, is there?
Sadly, no.
What's in here?
That's a restroom.
Uh-huh. No.
Sorry, I thought it rang.
Funny, when my phone rings, it rings. What's this?
What do you think it is?
Huh?
When you look at it, what do you see?
A lot of dead plants.
Dead? I paid good money for that.
Watch it.
Sorry. You're the one the police are looking for, aren't you?
Oh, I see my reputation has preceded me. That's right, I'm Glenda Wood. Now, what else do you know?
Nothing, really. You can ask the police.
Oh, you'd like that, now wouldn't you?
More than life itself. Let me rephrase that.
Now... What if I told you I could use you?
As what? A hostage? Something to stand behind and shoot?
What? This is just a precaution, really. I mean, the thing is with the... What's that?
I didn't hear anything.
You didn't?
No, no. I didn't hear that either.
Are you expecting someone?
Trust me, it's nobody I know. They don't knock, they just walk right in.
Look, here's what's gonna happen. I'm gonna be in here. Don't try anything funny because I'll be just inside listening. Get rid of whoever that is.
Oh, why can I have just called in sick today? Yes?
Am I interrupting something?
Yes, now is not a good time.
What are you doing?
Ah, no, I've already been in there.
What are you doing back here?
Well, I was wondering, has my sister come here yet?
Your sister?
Yeah, you see, the thing is, I may have called her and I may have told her about you.
What? Are you crazy?
Well, if I am, I'm certainly in the right place, am I right?
How could you do such a thing?
Well, she was desperate. And you know how family does things for family.
Okay, you have to talk to her,
She's here then?
Yes, you have to get her to listen to reason.
Well, then you obviously don't know my sister.
No, you have to try, Maybe she'll listen to you.
All right, I'll try. She's in there?
Yes, here, talk to her!
Who's he?
She's not your sister!
No, my sister's Kelly Dorsett, she's a reporter!
What? You're the one who called that reporter?
Yes!
The police kept blaming me for calling her.
Well, she's not a reporter yet.
What? She told me she was a reporter.
Yeah, you see, the thing is, she's just a copywriter.
But
she really wants to be a reporter, so I thought if she could get the story in, it fixed things nice and snug with her boss.
Really fixed it, all right.
Hey, remember me?
She has a gun.
Good, you're caught up.
Just let me think a minute, will you?
I mean, if she's one of your patients, you got your work cut out for you, don't you?
Now I have to do something about him as well.
Are you open for suggestions?
Here, get in here.
Been there, done that.
Get in there!
Like a speeding bullet! And by a speeding bullet, I mean, okay!
Now what?
First, I don't want you to get the wrong idea.
You show up here and you hold a gun on me. How many wrong ideas could there be?
I mean, you can help me.
How?
Look, I needed someone to listen to my side of things, and it had to be a psychiatrist.
And you chose me?
Oh, well, you go to Yellow Pages under psychiatrist and then Axelrod.
All right, I get the idea. But if you needed my help, you don't need to hold that gun on me.
I do, to make sure you'll listen to me and not phone the cops.
Is my brother in here?
Don't make a move!
What?
See what I told you? They don't knock, they just rush right in.
Who are you?
Who do you want me to be?
Who is she?
She's a reporter.
She's not a reporter yet, but she wants to be one.
Is that Greg?
You can hear us in there?
You can if you put your ear to the door.
That's all I need, a reporter.
Oh, you're the one the cops are looking for, aren't you?
No.
Well, after this, I'm sure they will be looking for you.
But just stand over next to him so I can think.
Man, you leave a room for 5 minutes and miss everything.
Look, why don't you just tell me why I need my help? I mean, what can I do for you?
I need you to convince them that I'm not in my right mind.
And how would I know that?
She has a gun. There's your hint.
Shut up!
No, really, I can be a great witness that you're nuts.
Oh, now I get it. You want to set up an insanity plea.
No, whatever, just give it to her. Do you need some kind of certificate? Do you have certificates?
I don't have certificates.
Well, at a time like this, don't you think you could just make one up?
You don't understand!
I'm trying to.
We both are, really.
What's going on out there?
I will get to you in a minute!
No hurry!
Dude, Bill, you're never gonna guess what I just... didn't know you had company.
Hold it right there!
See what I mean? They just rush right in. They don't knock. Doesn't matter what I'm doing in here.
Who are you?
Name's Tyrone. And I'm in advertising, so I don't make any money.
Shut up and stand over there with the others.
You know, you could warn a guy when something's happening in here. Maybe put up a sign or something.
You could try, I don't know, knocking?
Knocking? Who is she anyways?
I think she's the one the cops are looking for.
Who's that?
There's my brother, Greg.
He's the one who moved in my terrarium.
Where is he?
In the bathroom.
What is this thing he has at the restroom?
Look, Miss Wood, you have us all right where you want us. So obviously, the next move is yours.
Did you notice she has a gun?
I already told them that!
Somebody had to tell you that?
Look. I'll listen to whatever you have to say. You came here to talk to me, right?
Yes, I mean...
Just tell me what you came here to say. They're not going anywhere. I'm not going anywhere. Just tell me, how can I help you?
Can you two speak up?
He's getting to her.
Okay, both of you in there with him.
What?
You want us to go in the restroom?
Move!
Do what she says. Now!
Oh, I don't know how I'm going to explain this to my editor.
Yeah, that's my chief concern right now. What you're going to say to your editor.
Can I come out now?
No, we're coming in!
Wait, what?
Okay, now it's just you and me.
They can still hear us. Can you still hear us?
No!
Just talk quietly.
It's simply this. I need you to convince the authorities that I am not reliable.
You mean not responsible?
Whatever, you know the words. It's just, they have to understand that whatever I say will not hold up in court.
Look, I don't know a lot about the law, but I do know you're not required to say something that might incriminate you.
See, that's just what I'm telling you. You don't understand.
What? Just what is it that I'm not understanding? Can I get this? If I don't, it might look suspicious.
Go ahead, but nothing funny.
Furthest thing from my mind. Hello? Hi, no, I can't get to the restaurant right now. No, really, I can't explain. You're not at the restaurant? Well, then where are you? Moms, what are you doing there? What do you mean I'm just stalling for time?
Come on.
Name me one time when I tried to stall you. Okay, well, that was because of work. Well, that was because I was buying you a present. Okay, so I didn't buy you a present that time.
Excuse me, Dr. Axelrod, I was just wondering if it... Whoa!
Who are you?
Nobody, I was just looking for directions and
Hon,
I thought...
I really need to go, the police are here.
So you're the police?
I was hoping that wouldn't come up just now.
No, I am not making that up.
Get off the phone!
Did you hear that? And she has a gun! What do you mean that's a new one?
What?
I'm finished.
You know you can't get away.
Hey, the only people who know I'm here right now are all still here with me.
You mean just Dr. Axelrod and myself?
No, there's more.
In your mind?
Oh, for heaven's sake!
No.
They're right here!
Okay!
Get off me!
Sorry!
Where'd they come from?
Oh, just give them a door, and they'll all just barrel through it!
Why'd you let them out?
Miss Wood, you must see, this is futile.
Not yet. Like I said, the only people who know where I am are still here in this room.
Look, you have just left all three of these people in the restroom where they've been out of sight. I'll bet you anything you like, they all have cell phones. And as soon as you close that door, they all called somebody to come here.
Oh, my cell phone.
Yeah, I could have called Mac.
What's your excuse?
You call those excuses?
Nobody called anybody?
I told you I'm not going to call my editor to tell him I was held hostage in a bathroom.
So, it's like I said, nobody outside of this office knows I'm here right now. So if you'd all just relax and let me think.
She came here looking for a psychiatrist?
That's what she told me. I mean, that's what she specializes in, right?
I didn't tell you any of that.
You didn't tell me anything!
You're not relaxing!
You know, you don't gotta tell your editor everything, right?
I do if I want to be a first-rate reporter, don't I?
I know, but you gotta build your story up a little bit first. Use some hyperbole?
I said I was sorry.
People!
Don't tell me, tell her!
Why should I apologize to her?
I mean, you should deal with her!
How do you mean?
Well, you're in here with a known criminal. You gotta turn it into a life or death event.
Wait, I thought we were trying to avoid that.
Well, when you make your report, stick some excitement into it. You use the extremes, like, she's the most fierce, the most daring, the most wanted.
Hello?
Make it hot, like this. She burst through the door,
gun blazing.
I haven't fired a shot!
Holding several people, including this on-the-spot reporter, hostage.
That is good. That's really good.
Okay, okay. Obviously, she's scared, and she came to me to help with her defense.
What defense?
Will you people stop this?
Anyone in such a circumstance automatically relies on their instincts for survival.
Of course, but that means utilizing whatever means at their disposal.
And she uses the gun to that purpose.
Exactly.
You know, when you think about it, we're both in the same business here.
How so?
Well, it's just a matter of cause and effect. You only see the effect, whereas I look for the cause.
Then, while keeping a cool head, you remembered your obligation to your reading audience, and began to take notes!
Okay, too fast.
Hey, I have a gun.
Say, I never thought about it that way. You know, you and I can make a pretty great team.
Didn't I tell you that earlier?
I don't mean just on this case. I meant for all time.
I don't really know about that. I'm still
in the room here. What's with these people?
Hey, I just delivered a box of weeds, okay?
I just don't think I could obligate myself like that. I'm very busy.
Sounds like a qualification if you ask me.
Man, this thing writes itself.
Right now, in this moment, what do you think we should do psychologically?
Well, I don't think we're in any real danger.
What?
I mean, if you came here to shoot me, you could have done that the moment you stepped through my door.
Did she knock?
Oh, shut up.
Yes. I see. I don't even know why she has a gun. You don't need it, you know.
Don't I?
What are you doing?
We can make sure nothing happens to you.
I can't be sure of that. I mean...
Wait. Nothing happens to her. What about us?
Just give me the gun.
I wouldn't go that far.
Miss Wood? Thank you.
Wow.
Wait. She murders three psychiatrists and then just hands her gun over to you?
She didn't murder anyone.
No!
Wait, she's the one you've been looking for, isn't she? And she walks in waving a gun, doesn't she? So if she's not the killer, then who is she?
I'm not a killer, I'm a witness.
What?
Oh, that's why she's so scared. She thinks she's gonna be the next one to get bumped off.
Ty.
See what I'm talking about?
Miss Wood.
Oh, wait, no, Miss Wood. Look what you did.
You're so dumb, dude.
I mean, she's captured now, right?
Miss Wood, I think I can help you now.
So, I think I'm just gonna go now. Yeah.
Get me Captain Mulroney.
All this ruckus, over a witness.
I mean, it still makes for a good story though, right?
Not as good as if the real killer were here.
She's what? On her way over.
Now that I know what you're concerned about, won't you let me talk to you?
Kid, you're in on the ground floor here. Here's where you take it and run.
Right. Captain Mulroney's on her way over here.
Miss Wood, can you hear me?
I'm not coming out!
You can't just stay in there, you know.
Just leave me alone, all of you!
Hey, give me the chief. This is Kelly. Kelly Dorsett? I have the desk next to the water cooler. Yeah, that's me.
He just wants to help.
That's what you all keep saying. I come forth as a witness, and suddenly the killer gets off on some loophole, and then I have to live in fear for the rest of my life.
She's got a point.
Haven't you done enough today?
This is what I was afraid of. Well, what do you think we should do?
Well, we have to get her to calm down somehow.
Hey, Chief, you know that story about those three strings getting off? Well, I'm on top of it right now.
And how do you propose we do that?
Well, if we're all just calm, then maybe she'll relax long enough to come out so we can reason with her. That is, if everybody would just keep their mouths shut.
Wait. When you say everybody, you don't mean everybody. Wait. You just mean me, right?
Your grasp of the obvious is inspiring.
This is Kelly. Kelly Dorsett.
So,
You're going to help us out after all.
Well, of course.
See what I mean? We could really use someone like you.
This is different.
No, it's not.
This is personal.
And that's how I always feel about a case. Look, don't you ever want to take a chance? Ever want to get involved? Is this all you see in your future? Just sitting here in this office, letting the hours go by, just always watching from the sidelines, just seeing and not doing like a
fly on the wall.
Exactly.
I heard one of my patients say that.
I thought you couldn't reveal anything said to you by a patient.
I'll fill you in later, Chief, and believe me, I'm in on the ground floor of this one. I'll explain that later.
Well, I sure hope I'm interrupting something.
Captain Mulroney, I was just about to call you.
Well, it seems like there's been way too much phone calling today, if you ask me.
What?
Somebody phoned the commissioner and complained about my kidding around during the investigation.
How do you know it was me?
It was me.
Then you haven't heard.
Heard what?
We have her, Glenda Wood, our witness.
What? She's here? Where is she?
Locked in the restroom.
Good. Now she can't get away.
Just doing my job.
Now, if you all just leave and I can deal with Miss Wood.
Shouldn't I stay too?
No, I'm sure I can reason with her.
Maybe I should remain. She did come here looking for me, after
Look,
all.
Look, sir, I've been on the force for a long time, more years than I care to remember. I have dealt with witnesses like this before, so if you all just depart the premises and allow me to do
Dr.
my
Rexrod,
job...
Dr. Rexrod, I have your next appointment.
What next appointment?
Now, where did I leave off?
Mrs. Starling is here now?
Well, you told me to schedule her as soon as possible.
Ma'am, I was just letting everyone know we have to clear the room right now.
Fine!
Don't close the door!
Make up your mind.
Hey, I've stayed here this long. I'm not leaving now.
We'll give you a statement once we've concluded here.
Miss Wood, the police captain is here now, so I can assure you that you'll come to no harm.
Ah, very good.
Thank you.
So, do I stay or do I leave?
Leave, please, all of you.
We're clearing the room so you can come out now.
Yeah, and then what?
Just take it one step at a time. Nobody is forcing you to do anything.
I still think I should stay for backup.
I have backup. Officer Thurlow is outside.
I should remain as well, as I said.
And just what did you do to Officer Thurlow anyway? He won't stop talking about trees and bunny rabbits.
Miss Wood?
Dr. Axelrod. You didn't tell her about the bank robbery I was involved in, did you?
You held up a bank?
No, I didn't rob a bank.
Then just what are you talking about?
You see, I was driving into the bank parking lot, and I ran into their getaway car.
Ma'am, I'm not concerned about that right now. Right now, I'm concerned about capturing a desperate criminal, and I am here to put the lid on this case once and for all.
So you're not here for me?
Of course not. That's her!
What?
She's the one! She's the killer!
Mrs. Starling, you can't mean she's the one.
I don't think that's me. I'm pretty sure I would have remembered that.
Not her! The other one!
Captain Mulroney.
I recognized her voice!
What?
She's confused, that's all. She's deluded. No, she's the one, I tell you. That's why I couldn't go to the police, don't you see?
Miss Wood, you mean...
All right, everyone, just remain as you are.
Captain Mulroney, you don't mean that you are the...
Didn't have a clue, did you? Earlier when I said there was a murderer in the room, I wasn't kidding.
It's all beginning to make sense now. How you took a special interest in this case and how much you despise psychiatrists.
Right the first time, Lieutenant. I hate them. We spend months tracking down our killers, and then these doctors get them off with some hocus-pocus about them not being in their right minds. Well, I took it for years, and then I knew it was time for a change, and I was just the one to do it.
So you killed them?
10 out of 10 for you, Lieutenant. Too bad no one will ever find out. Now, all of you, that's out of the room, now!
What are you gonna do?
Oh, what do you think?
She's gonna kill us all!
Ty, she doesn't need any suggestions from you!
That's right, now all of you flat against the wall now, and don't think you can stall for time, Diana! Don't think you can stall for time! I tell you everything!
Oh! I am so sorry.
Don't worry about it, officer.
Let me get your gun for you.
No, Calvin!
No! Calvin! I wouldn't do that if I were you!
Well, what are you doing?
Do as he says, Calvin.
Dr. Axelrod? Have you lost your happy place?
Captain Mulroney! Captain Mulroney, she's the one. She's the killer.
Do what?
She's telling the truth, Calvin. She just confessed.
She is...
You!
Don't listen to them, Officer Thurlow. Just give me that gun.
A quiet clearing. And there's bunnies and squirrels.
What's going on in here?
Commissioner!
That's what I was gonna tell you. The commission is here.
There's your killer, Captain Mulroney. She did it.
They're crazy, all of them.
And you're the only one who's sane in here?
Hey, in this room, you can't throw a rock without...
Shut up!
I can't explain, really, I can't.
Oh, she's done her explaining already, how she murdered all the other psychiatrists, and we have plenty of witnesses for her confession.
I see. That explains your plane ticket to Mexico.
What?
They called into the station house to confirm your reservation. Officer Thurlow, arrest this woman.
Whatever you say, Commissioner.
You can put down your gun now, Lieutenant.
Thank you. Lucky thing. Gun's not loaded.
What? Are you getting all this?
Yeah. So they really don't need me as a prime witness anymore, right?
No. Everything's fine. You go with them, Miss Wood.
Whatever you say. You're the doctor.
And this is Glenda Wood, our witness.
Got the witness and the killer. Nice job, Lieutenant.
Thank you, but can't take all the credit. I had some help.
You, sir?
Yes.
Thank you for the assistance.
Of course.
Let's take her in, Thurlow.
Let's go, Captain.
Wait, Commissioner! What brought you down here? What tipped you off? Can I get a picture, just me and you?
Well, looks like my work here is done.
It's over.
Ty.
Yeah?
Get out.
Okay. Mrs. Axelrod?
Mom, what are you doing back here? Weren't you leaving?
Oh, yeah.
Aw, I just came down here to give you this.
So you finally took a chance, didn't you?
I did, didn't I?
And it felt good, didn't it?
Here.
That's our engagement ring.
I know. Your ex-fiance came over and gave it to me to give to you. She said she's tired of all of your excuses. I told you she was flighty.
I had a feeling something like this was going to happen.
So did I, but you didn't listen. Seems to me you have a bit more spare time on your hands. I'm a detective. I can tell these things, so... How about my offer?
Say, you are that lovely policewoman now, aren't you?
Yes.
What would you think to having lunch with me and my son sometime? How about on Sunday?
Oh, ma'am, I would love to. However, I always spend Sundays with my mother, so maybe next time?
I like her.
Dr. Axelrod, I have a phone call for you.
Oh, now what?
He say he... Nicholas Cage.
Nicholas Cage?
I don't know who that is.
Yes? Who? Nicholas Cage! Nick Cage! Mr. Cage! Why, yes. She is here. Mrs. Starling, it's for you.
For heaven's sake, I told him not to bother me while I'm here. Hello? Nikki, how are you? You're writing your autobiography? Of course, you can use my name. Absolutely. Say, did you put the elephant in my backyard?
Thank you.
bang, dango, tango, angle bang. And it keeps things curious. Oh, but it makes folks curious. All that does it takes two parts tango and a little ting tango tang. Bring a moment to orangutanga like me and you. I used to think that you are a tomboy, had like a bird's nest, close so shoddy. Then I found you are a rhomboid, not no bless phone in your body. So down, mess around with my temple, rango bang, bit of mama. At bars in dark, do little less that rang bang. Go have some tango.
Thank you to the tech booth, Alvin, Megan, Jonas, John Hazelrig for building our set, Jim McMillan for doing anything I ask him to do, Ashley Erickson and the Art Club for painting our flats. Have a good night.